I think we have far more in common as Catholics than we do that which divides us. And I hope that maybe even that people can see in that a little bit of what the end result is, that, you know, most of the things that I'm writing about are things that we can all agree on, are, you know, acts of faith and advancing, you know, Catholic ideals. I was reminded of this parish that my oldest son and I had visited that was built by Lithuanian immigrants, and they have a Lithuanian mass every third Sunday, and he and I had attended it on a few occasions. And I was just reminded of it, and I just thought to myself, I would attend mass in all the parishes in the diocese, the Gary diocese, and no sooner than I thought that than I said, no, I had to attend mass in all 50 states and the District of Columbia and Puerto Rico. That's 52. I could do it in a year. And that was it. By the time I got home that day, I had pretty much the idea for the book in place, that I would go and I would just write about something at each parish that I visited, and, you know, and just try to hopefully tell a story of us as Catholics in, you know, in the United States in 2021. And so I've been writing professionally my entire adult life. I worked for newspapers for 12 years. I did some freelance work, not very successfully, for a couple. And then for the last 15 years, I've been writing for a trade magazine.
She says she doesn't want to have an event where she can't hug people. We welcome today Daniel Markham. Daniel is an author from the Chicago area who's currently writing a book called 52 Masses. And he's going to a church in every state in Washington, D.C. and Puerto Rico, and we're the parish that he's visiting in New York State. So we're very happy to have him here. He's been here for all the masses this weekend.
A lot of the things I'm doing I could do by phone. You know, I spoke with Father here and Sister Jeremy, you know, and I got a lot of the information, but it's, you know, without the without coming to Mass, without worshiping with the people that I'm writing about, without meeting them, it's incomplete. and I, you know, it's so much a part of the experience, even if the Mass visit itself isn't really much of a part of what I'll end up writing about, which is the case in some instances of where I'm going. Here, you know, largely it won't be about the Mass, but, you know, to just be part of these communities and worship with them, you know, it's, you know, I wouldn't do it without it. And so... You know, but I like some of the other things that are going on here. I think it's just I think what some of the things you do are quite innovative, and I liked what I heard about the parish. It just immediately appealed to me, and I haven't been disappointed. You know, one of the things that I really appreciated was the different perspectives that I get in the homilies when I happen to sit, like today where, you know, there were, you know, multiple priests delivering their homilies. And so you get these different perspectives on the same, you know, the same scripture reading. And it's really interesting, because I guess I had really thought about that so many of our priests, you know, come at the priesthood and come at the faith from different perspectives, from different, uh, you know,
different histories.
Like we said, the idea, you know, of presenting the church and its people in a good light and hoping to tell a story of who we are as a people of faith. I would also like, I would like that maybe people are able to use it as kind of a cookbook, that they can take ideas that are successful in one parish and say, this might be something that we can do in our own. You know, this is an area that we struggle with, whether it's maybe, you know, keeping our young people engaged. And so they see what the people in Minnesota are doing on that front, and maybe they're able to, if not directly copy, maybe they reach out to them and say, what do you, you know, how did you manage this? How did you manage to be successful at this? So I hope that people can take, you know, maybe take parts of it and say, that's something that we could do, or you know, that's something I could do as to, you know, to make myself a better person. You know, I can follow this person's example. And then I also, I just hope that maybe, you know, maybe someone sees, you know, maybe someone who's, maybe somebody whose faith is weaker, or somebody whose faith is, they're not yet Catholic, or you know, just something that maybe they see in one of these stories, something that inspires them to, you know, to strengthen their faith, to, you know, to get more engaged in their parish. Because they see, you know, that there are, you know, there are people like them. And I think that's the one that I think that I hope that the thing that I, that people can see, that the people that I'm writing about are largely just like you and I, that, you know, there are a lot of, you know, just average people just who are doing really good things. And, you know, and we, you know, they're, you know, that they can take something from that and be inspired, you know, by them. I mean, it's just, you know, I'm just blessed with really great people to be writing about. So, you know, it's not me. If it happens, it's because the people that I'm writing about are really inspiring themselves.